show. Wow, what a treat, Josh. That was amazing. That was really good. I was watching the 12 strings, like, wow, the way you play it, that's like really cool. But your voice is very full.
Thank you.
You got like a hearty voice. So this is great. Josh is going to take us out at the end of the show with another song. I want to talk to Mark about, Mark, tell us about some of your most memorable moments sitting across a table from an artist. Like, tell us who the artist would be and a funny story or a memorable story.
So it's probably got to go back to how I got started in the business. And that goes back to simply just not wanting to go to Vietnam.
There you go.
As a kid, right?
Wow, so, that's interesting.
You know, every night you get downstairs, mom and dad, sisters, brothers, you know, we saw Walter Cronkite, the most trusted voice in news, and all you saw were body bags coming off the air. So I said, Mom, Dad, they're going to grab me, without a doubt.
How old were you then? 19, 18?
16. 16, but you know, when I was turning 18. So he said, what do you want to do? I like music. I used to ask my dad, you know, hey, Dad, how come the drums for the Beatles are coming out of the left speaker and the vocals are coming out of the right speaker? My dad was like,
I don't know.
I'll go find out. You know? So I went to this place called the Institute of Audio Research in Manhattan. And I went there for 2 years at night after school during the day. And then the day after I graduated from high school, I had my little certificate in hand.
Nice.
And I was on a plane to London, England, and I just pounded the streets of London.
And how come you picked London? Because of the hub, music hub?
All my favorite records had studios in London.
There you go.
You know, Led Zeppelin, Elton John.
Beatles, and all
you know,
that.
These were all the studios I wrote down. Yeah, I got to go to Olympic Studios.
That's a pretty big initiative as a... as a teenager.
There weren't really any other options. I did that. Anyway, I walked the streets of London, luckiest kid in the world, I got a job at Air Studios through, I went there to see Joyce, the studio manager. She wasn't there. They said, come back the next day.
You didn't know this person?
No. And they said, come back the next day. And I came back the next day, and the receptionist wasn't there. So I started walking down the hallway of the main corridor of Air Studios, and this English kid, Nigel Walker, comes out and he goes, can I help you? And I said, I'm here to meet with Joyce. He goes, oh, Joyce isn't here today. He goes, hey, where's your accent from? And I said, I'm from New York City. Oh, I love New York.
Really?
Come on in. And so I go into this session and there's Alan Clark, who's the lead singer for the Hollies.
Wow.
Right? That's a big hit, Long Cool Woman in the Black Dress. The Dee Murray on bass from Elton John. And, just a... great musicians and I'm just sitting there just hanging out.
Wow.
And then I said, I'm going downstairs. I smoked at the time. I'm going out there, pack a smoke. Anyone want a coffee or a smoke? So it's like I took an order.
Yeah.
So I went downstairs, came back and then I said, do you mind if I come back tomorrow? And they said, no, come on back.
That's great.
And I started hanging out at Air Studios. And then Joyce came to me and said, hey, do you want a job? I want a job. Of course I want a job.
But you hung around. You were paying your dues.
Yeah.
Hung around, right? That's what you do, right? You hang around.
Right.
Until they kick you out or they bring you in. There you go.
So I was hanging out. And then they started assigning me to sessions. And one of the first major sessions was Live and Let Die, Paul McCartney.
Wow. And you did have experience because you went to school.
I wasn't anywhere near the console. I was emptying ashtrays and rolling up mic cables.
So tell us about this now.
But I'm hanging out with Sir George and Paul and Wings and a 63-piece orchestra.
So Paul would have been 40 maybe around then.
Yeah,
40, right? And that was. So where was it in his career when you were there? Where was he right there?
Well, he had Wings. He had just started Wings.
Okay.
Yeah. So Wings was up and running, and then of course he got commissioned to do with Sir George the soundtrack for Live and Let Die.
What a song that is.
Yeah, I mean, live off the floor.
So tell us about that.
So the band was set up, the orchestra was set up, and I set up all these ashtrays and stuff around, and all the mics were set up, and it was live off the floor.
Wow.
The only thing they overdubbed were the vocals and the guitar solo.
And how was Paul?
Huh? Paul's great. I remember cleaning up. I had to clean up the whole session. And, I'm out emptying the ashtray, sweeping the floor, rolling up the cable, putting the mics away and everything. And Sir Paul comes down. He just sits down at the piano and just starts, hey, Mark. Where are you from? New York. Oh, yeah, I love New York. Yeah, we started our career there in New York, you know. And we just had like an hour and a half conversation, you know, and I'm sitting there going,
you must be pinching yourself.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Like that's good. Do you remember what songs he was playing
on?
No, just
all
whatever,
kinds
practicing,
of old blues songs and, you know.
Just, nice guy, though?
Yeah, great guy. Great guy, eh? Great guy.
I mean, I could ask for another story, but I don't think he's going to top that one. Like, how about David? Mention something about Bowie.
So, David Bowie. So, Michael Barrickman was the A&R guy at EMI.
Okay.
And I had been doing a lot of remixing for Polygram, and he liked my work, and he said, you know, we got this new Bowie record coming into EMI. He had just signed with EMI. It was like one of the biggest deals out there. And they said, we want you to go to Never Let Me Down. Right?
Oh, okay, yeah.
So I went in, and first he said, you know, you got to meet with Bowie and stuff like that. And so I go up to his manager's office and have a sit down. But then I said, you know, what do you think? What are you looking for? And he goes, just do what you do.
Really, eh?
Yeah. He goes. You're here because I like what you do. Just do what you do.
This is David.
David Bowie. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Just do what you do. You know,
like, I mean, such a superstar.
So you know, I don't have to look over your shoulder.
So you know, for the musicians that are just breaking into the business, tell them exactly what you do for them, like in a nutshell, if you can.
From a production standpoint.
Put it this way. Let's do this. So don't take Josh for an example, because we already talked about Josh, but take a musician who's watching me right now. Mm-hmm. Like, he's watching right now, and he thinks he's pretty good, and he says, wow, you know what, I'd love to sort of follow Josh's, mm-hmm. you know, journey.
Yeah.
Tell what they would do and what you do for them.
Well, like I said, it's a song thing. The songs have to stick to me as a producer, and I got to be able to walk down the street humming a melody.
Okay.
You know, which I'm sure, you know, the last song that Josh did, you're going to hum that melody.
Yeah.
Na, 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 na.
Exactly.
So when that sticks to me as a producer, that tells me, okay, there's something there, you know. Basically, so it all comes down to the songs. And then if the production is not cool, I'll tell them it's not cool.
Okay.
Maybe you need to go back in the studio.
Pump it up a little bit or whatever.
Yeah, or do a remix or do some overdubs or... you know, other stuff, you know.
That's great. And before I let you go, I do want to say, I want to thank Mark, because we had such a special weekend up in Wasaga. We went up to see rock legend Burton Cummings, you know, and I want to thank Sam. And they were so nice to us, Sam and Burton and his team.
Sam's great.
And it was a great concert.
Yeah.
He still can pump it up.
Yeah,
he's got the pipes. It was sold out show.
Yeah.
Beautiful venue up in Wasaga Beach.
Yeah, I missed that show, but I saw the one at Casino Rama a few months ago.
It was so good. So stay tuned, because hopefully we're going to be doing some great things with Burton and AMG and Sony and Mark. And so this is great. So before we let you go, Mark, if people want to find out more information, where could they get in touch with you?
They can go to theamgcorp.com, which is our company website.
Okay.
And everything about me and the company and what we do and how we do it is all there. I'm all over social
media.
That's
great. I really appreciate being on the show today. Why don't we get Josh to take us out with one of a great cover song that we talked about. He can start it up, and he'll just take us right out. We'll see you next time. Again, I'm Jay Stoy, and you're watching Wild Child Records. Do comment on Facebook, please. Thank you.
Well, I mean, talking about New York and New Jersey, I grew up on a very healthy diet of Northeastern rock and roll. My dad is a big Springsteen fan. Actually followed Springsteen on tour for a little bit when he was in university, and played in a Springsteen cover band. So one of my first memories of hearing music and hearing music with a story.
Love the Boss.
Was Springsteen.
Love the Boss.
So
I'll
do a little Springsteen.
Sure.
Thank you.
want to thank you for being on the show today. Hey, everybody out there who's watching on Facebook, we're going to be switching over to Twitch because we're going to be doing open mic hosted by veteran Vince Campbell. Hey, remember to hug a veteran today, right? We owe them 100%. So, again, you're watching Wild Child Records. I'm Jay Stoyan. We'll see you next time.